Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. And today I wanted to do a review of my Gucci Boston bag. This is the size 25. And I wanted to talk to you about what fits inside, how I like to carry it, and what are my general thoughts, pros and cons about this particular bag. So let's get on with it. So if you've seen my unboxing of this, I think I did it on my Instagram reels. This bag is from stylishtop.com.au, which is a reseller here in Australia. They are based in Melbourne, and I have actually been to their physical store. It's on Elizabeth Street. I think it's 115 Elizabeth Street. For those of you who follow me on Instagram, and I'm going to link that in the description box down below and also on the screen, I have been eyeing the Louis Vuitton Speedy Bandolier 25. But the price of that here in Australia is, I believe, 2,650 Australian dollars. There's something about the Damier Azure that really draws me to that. I don't know if you can tell from my collection. I'll show you a picture of the recent collection that I've got somewhere on the screen. I have predominantly darker colored bags, so I wanted something light. But I was also quite afraid of light colored bags for the reason of color transfer and really looking quite dirty and outdated very quickly, right? So I was umming and ahhing, and I was also deliberating between, do I buy new, do I buy pre-loved? Because the ones that I see on pre-loved is just a couple of $100 cheaper than brand new. Is it worth, you know, saving that amount of money for a secondhand versus buying a brand new one? So those were some of the things that I was considering. But I was also looking at several of these. I know this came in a different colorway as well. The one with the red and green webbing. And I think it was more of a brown, brown leather instead of the navy that I have here. But and even the ones that are on the same colorway, a lot of them were the 32cm ones, the larger version of it. And I know myself, I don't really carry that much, and I don't really want to bring such a big bag because I have a tendency to fill empty spaces. So if I have a big bag, I can guarantee that I will bring with me things that I don't even need to have with me, just because I don't like the idea of bringing such a big bag and not having anything in it. So anyway, and I'm sure I'm not alone about that. I saw this on stylishtop.com.au, and I'm gonna put the name of the shop and on the screen. And I looked at it. I looked at any of the damages. There was a little bit of scuffing on the corners, but nothing like on this corner here. There's a little bit of scuffing I can see, and also on the other side. And I suspect it has to be because of it didn't come with its own dust bag, so they provided me with a different one, and it's quite a snug fit. So every time that I have to put it in the dust bag, I can feel that it's scratching onto the leather. So, but also I like to keep my bags in their dust bags because that's what they're for. Okay. But anyway, talk about the bag. So it is the 25cm size of this Boston bag. I think they call it the mini Boston. It's beautiful. It's got that navy Gucci monogram against a gray canvas. And then there's leather, navy leather trimmings. The hardware is light gold. And you've got that red and blue Gucci webbing. And inside, I'll show you, there's a zip pocket on the inside, and it will have that leather tab, and underneath that leather tab would be the serial number. And then on the opposite side of that, there are two slip pockets. Then there's nothing else. It's really just, and look at how clean the interior of this bag is. The only thing that I noticed was a little bit of staining on this side, which you probably can't even tell. Which if I was brave enough to put this in the wash, I probably would be able to get rid of that dirt, but I just don't want to do that. The bottom of this bag has four metal feet. You can see that. So 1, 2, 3, 4. And it already came with the long strap, as you can see here. Now, this long strap here is not very long, and I will put up some pictures of mod shots and where this bag would sit on me. This particular long strap has got 1, 2, 3, 4 holes for you to be able to adjust it, and I am already on the longest setting. And even at the longest setting, it's not long enough for crossbody. You can see in the picture here that I'm putting up that on crossbody, it actually hits more my waist, and I'm high-waisted, so it hits more my waist, whereas when I wear it on my shoulder, it's more sitting on the hip bone. Just at the spot where I can comfortably still place my hand on the bag. Okay, carrying it handheld is actually, I've noticed, my more preferred way of carrying it. Unless I've got a lot of things to bring with me, that's the only time that I would actually put it on my shoulder, but most of the time I would carry it handheld, which in hindsight, I actually thought, oh, maybe a regular Speedy would have been enough for me instead of going for the bandolier. But I wanted the bandolier because I wanted to have a strap in case I wanted to carry it crossbody. Now, this already came with that. How much did I pay for this? I believe it was $551 after the 5% sale. But anyway, I think that's still a really good good price to pay for this. And I didn't really want to pay too much if... not knowing whether I would actually enjoy carrying the bag as much as I actually do. And it's just the right size for me, also for my frame. And just the rolled leather handles is just in perfect condition. It's almost as if the original owner didn't really use it that much. So that's that. I also like that this particular bag has zips that go all the way to the side so that you can really open up the bag. Now, when I carry the bag, I actually have an organizer inside. I don't really need to have an organizer, to be honest, but I just don't like it like slouching like that. So I would always use this one just to for it to keep the shape. Because it's canvas, the structure is not very firm, and it could deform very quickly. So this particular organizer is from Katie Australia. I have another one in a similar color for my YSL bucket bag that I had custom made by Katie Australia. I'm not affiliated with them. This is not a sponsored video. They don't know who I am. I buy my own. I pay my own. I even pay for shipping. Okay. So, but anyway, if you were looking for a local Australian business for that, for your organizer, this is pretty good. It's actually made of really thick felt material, so it really holds the shape. What do I carry here? So I've got my, in this pocket here on the side, I've got my hand sanitizer. I try to bring my DJI pocket, I think this is the second version, yeah, pocket 2 with me whenever I go out. I've got my medium kirigami, which, you know, your cosmetic pouch, essentially. I have my small kirigami, which I use as my wallet. You can probably hear my coins there. And And I've got my sunglasses, which I didn't even bother to take out of its large bulky case because it fits just fine. Right. And I bring as well a pack of tissue, as you do. This one also comes with a water bottle holder, so if you wanted to do that. So anyway, that's what I carry in my bag. So my hand sanitizer fell out. So I'm just gonna put this back in there. And by the way, when I ordered this at Katie Australia, I went on their website. This is not custom made for this particular one. I just went to the categories, went for under Louis Vuitton for a Speedy 25. And this fits perfectly into this bag because this is also a size 25, as you can see. So it's right in there. And yeah, that's pretty much what I carry with me on the daily. So pretty much all of my essentials and then some. Now, in terms of pros and cons, really the only con that I could think about for this one is that it is canvas. So there is a possibility of this getting stained if you spill anything on it. But it also means that the structure doesn't hold very well, because one of the things that I have noticed about this before I started using the organizer inside is that it sags at the bottom, and it still kind of does now. So the feet don't actually hit the surface. It's more this part here with the webbing. So I didn't want that. That's why I wanted to get an organizer. Now, in terms of pros, because I bought this pre-loved, I didn't have to spend so much money, and it already came with the strap, so I didn't have to buy extra. If I bought a secondhand Speedy, I would have bought the bag for probably $600, $750, maybe even up to $1,000 secondhand without the strap. So yeah, I think that was a pretty good buy. It holds a lot. It does have a tendency to become heavy, depending on what you put in it, but that's a given. And also, I want to say that without anything in it, it's actually very light. I was contemplating on getting an all leather version of this that I found in Vestiaire, but I was thinking, if it's already made of leather, then it's probably going to be a little bit heavy. And then when you start putting stuff in it, it's probably going to, you know, be a little bit heavier. So, and if I was going to carry it the crook of my arm, it's going to be, you know, uncomfortable at some point. So there, that is my review, what fits inside, and mod shots of my Gucci Boston bag. I hope you enjoy that. Let me know in the comment section down below if you have any questions about this particular bag, and if you have any suggestions on videos that you want me to put up here. The next video that I'm probably gonna put up would be what else is on my wish list. So we'll get on to that. See you all again in the next video. Bye.